Don't think you're the only one. Don't think you're the only one. Don't think you're the only one. You're not the only one. You don't know.
comes from the Gospel of Luke. Because I always like to back things up with scripture. Can you say amen?
Amen.
Turn with me to St. Luke, the 23rd chapter. I hear them pages turn. I love to hear pages turn. It does something to me. St. Luke, the 23rd chapter. Starting at the 32nd verse. And it reads like this. And it says, and there were also. That means he went by himself. There was also two others, malefactors, that were led with him to be put to death. And when they had come to the place, which is called Calvary, that they crucified him and the malefactors, one on the right and one on the left. Can you say amen?
Amen.
Now, I want to put a plug right there. It seems like every time mess gets started, it's always two.
Uh-oh.
It's always two people that's in a disagreement. One feel one way and one feel another. And it takes two to tangle, is what it said. It takes two to dance. It takes two to argue. It takes two. Because I ain't never seen nobody arguing by themselves. Can you say amen?
Amen.
I ain't never seen nobody in a disagreement in a mirror talking to themselves.
No.
Normally when there's a disagreement, it's a disagreement between two. But yet it's still, here is Jesus the Christ in the middle of two malefactors. And malefactors was, these were men that had been led to death by the Roman government because they had committed treason. And treason was punishable by death. By death. So Jesus was hanging on a cross with two guilty people. And here Jesus was, the Bible said, even Pilate said, I find no fault in him. Jesus had been led from judgment hall to judgment hall. And the Bible said that he had been tried six times in six different courts. But yet and still they found no fault in him in all the courts that he had been found. Six is also the number of man. Can you say amen?
Amen.
And here is our Lord and our Savior hanging on a cross with nails in his hands, with spikes in his feet, and with a crown of thorns placed on his head, hanging on a cross. From the sixth until the ninth hour, Jesus the Christ, the Son of God, was hanging on a cross. And let me tell you, there was no guile found in him. He that knew no sin became sin for us, so that we may become righteous in the sight of God. And while Jesus was on this cross, he looked and he said, Father, God, I feel your Holy Ghost. This was the last prayer that Jesus prayed. This was the last prayer that Jesus prayed. And Jesus prayed, he said, Father, forgive them, for they don't know what they do. Father, forgive the Roman government. Father, forgive the Jews. Forgive the Sanhedrin Council. Forgive all those that are standing watching me be persecuted. Now what Jesus was really doing, Jesus was really cleaning himself up. He was showing us that we are saved, sanctified, filled with the Holy Ghost. How that we got to learn to forgive? Put your hands together. Put your hands together. Hell is full of people that were saved. Hell is full of people that were sanctified. But they also forgot to forgive. And Sister Janet sent me a videotape. And in the videotape, this young girl went to hell with Jesus. And Jesus was weeping and crying while he was in hell. And he was crying for the saints that had did good, preached good sermons, laid hands on the sick, and they recovered. And but yet and still, they were in hell. And it bothered me. And I began to look at the videotape, and all kind of people were in hell from ages past up until the time present. Thousands and thousands and thousands upon thousands were in hell because of unforgiveness. I stopped by to tell you, while I was in the pulpit, God spoke to me. He said, Miracle House of Prayer. He said, you is going to have to forgive one another, no matter who was wrong, no matter who was right, no matter what went on, no matter what was done. Baby, you got to forgive if you want to go forward, if you want to be blessed, if you want God to move, if you want your finances to come up. You gotta forgive. If you wanna move forward, I feel God. You got to let it go. If you want God to move in your life, you got to let it go. Say yeah. Even a prophet, even this prophet, I had an issue. I had a real serious issue. Y'all sound shy. I'm human too. So I want to pull myself out. I had a problem. My daddy died about a year ago on the 28th of this month. And I wasn't prepared for it. My mama died and God prepared me for that. I went to the funeral director school just so I could bury my mama. Can you say yeah?
Yes.
Cause I asked God to help me with that. But I wasn't prepared for that. Daddy been preaching almost 70 years. Pastor and preaching 70 years. He was my friend. I could count on him. I could call him. But one day, Sunday morning, at 11 a.m., the telephone rang, and I looked at the clock. What in the world my sister doing calling me at 11 o'clock? At this time, Daddy ought to be in the pulpit. Why is she calling me? But she called me, and she said, he gone. Who gone? What you talking about? She said, Daddy, it's gone. Gone where? He gone. I said, my God, wait a minute. I ain't had no warning. I ain't seen nothing, but he gone. My God. And then my sisters and my son, they felt like they could do something that they really weren't prepared to do. They meant well, but I didn't see what they meant. I saw the results of what they did. Can you say yes, Lord? And they took Daddy and they took him to a funeral home that I didn't approve of. They put it together. I didn't approve of it. I didn't like the arrangement. I thought Daddy deserved better than that. I had a problem with my own son, my oldest son. I have a problem with my baby sister, and I told him I ain't gonna never forgive you the way you treated my daddy. You don't treat him like this. I ain't got nothing to say to nobody. I was mad. I went to bed mad. I couldn't eat because I was mad. When I went to work mad. Come on, let's go, let's go, let's go. Move, 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 move. I was mad. I ain't never been that mad. Do you hear what I'm saying? I was so mad, my wife wouldn't even speak to me. She knew I was mad. All she kept doing was praying for me. And she kept saying to me, you have to pray about that. You got to pray about it. I ain't praying about nothing. I'm mad. I walk around mad. I look mad. I act mad. I'm mad. Just like the devil. I'm mad. Don't even speak to me. You speak to me, I might blow up. I was mad. And I began to realize I'm the only one mad. I'm the only one messed up. I'm the only one that can't sleep. I'm the only one that can't eat. They ain't thinking about me. I'm mad at the world. And the world are gone on and left me behind. And so I fell on my face. I said, Lord, I said, Lord, I need some help. God, I have sinned. I sinned against you. I sinned against my children. I sinned against my family. Lord, I repent. Save me, God. Deliver me, God. Help me, God. Hey! Hallelujah. And then I got up off the floor. And then when I got up, I felt better. I got my shirt back. I got my dance back. I got it all back. I got it back. I said I got it back. Woo! Woo! I feel lighter now. I got my dance back. I got my dance back. I got my groove back. I go to work dancing. I come home dancing. I see my wife, I say, hey, baby. I'm dancing, woo, because I got my soul back, standing all over the house. If there be any sick in the house, if there be anybody that need repenting, if there be anybody that want to rededicate yourself to God, if there be anybody that want God to do something special for you, I need you to meet me on these two rows right here against the wall. He said he wanted to get right with God. He got a heart problem. I'm so glad you came, because I had a heart problem too. And God gave me a new heart. And if God gave me a new heart, who am I that he wouldn't give one to you? But I prophesy to you that you're going to live and not die.
Hallelujah.
Give me that arm, bishop. Yes. Yeah. Raise your hands higher. Higher, yeah, 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 yeah. Higher, yeah. Higher, God. Yeah, higher. Yeah, God. And I say to you, and I say to you, that you shall live and not die. Let me touch your heart right there. I command you to hear the word of God. I command you to come new. I command you as a prophet of God that you shall be healed, delivered, and set free in the name of Jesus. That you can preach the word of God. This is an attack from the devil, because you are made to preach the word of God. No more doubt. No more doubt. No more doubt. Go back to the doctor. Go back to the doctor. She said she ain't healing in her body. Now, you know, really, she didn't have to tell me that. Because I saw that, and when you were sitting there, I saw an angel standing behind you. And his angel had his wings like this. And the angel was covering you. And he had chiffon kind of color. What kind of color is that? But he was over you. God, I thank you. I speak life to your body. God gave me this sermon is because all of us, even me, had to forgive from stuff in the past so that we may get a healing in today. This was in my sermon, that you got to let some stuff go so that you can stand up, be healed, be delivered, and be set free.
Yeah.
Do you believe it? First lady,
yes.
You got healing hands.
Yes.
God told me y'all first lady got healing hands.
Praise God.
Yeah, call me your first lady.
Hallelujah.
Come on, come on.
Yeah.
This is an awesome welcome, God.
Yeah.
And we can appreciate our home.
Yeah.
We will truly be blessed.
Yeah.
Yeah, come on, your woman, God. Come on.
Yeah.
Lay hands on her. Lay hands. Lay hands on her belly. Lay hands on her belly. Lay hands on her. That's a prophet of God. I see life in your body. Be healed. Be delivered. And be set free. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Now anoint your head. From the crown of your head. To the soles of your feet. I decree healing in your body. I need a bottle of unopened water. Let me anoint this water. Bishop, anoint this water with me. As the head of this house, the bishop, the soul pastor, we declare healing. We declare cleansing. We declare that your body become new. From the crown of your head to the sole of your feet. God, we thank you. And we give you praise for it. In Jesus' name. I want you to drink that water. I want you to drink that water. I want you to drink that water. I feel the anointing. I feel the anointing. This is all the working. This is the working of a miracle. Yes, drink it, baby. You ain't got to drink it all. You can take the rest with you. But when I go back, when you go back to the doctor, you will see a change in your life. That's going to be a change. That's going to be a change. You shall live and not die. I promise that to you. This ain't your time. The devil is a liar. And he's a thief. And he comes to rob, steal, and kill you. But I promise that to you that your work on earth ain't done.
No, no.
And you're going to live and continue to do the work of God.
Yeah.
This is only a test, baby.
Yeah.
This is only a test. This is what God needed to get you to the place where he can show you that he's a healer. You are a prophetess of God. You will lay hands on the sick and they shall recover. When God gets good with you, you are going to become used by God. In the same area that you was attacked, now you are going to defeat the devil. Come on, give God some praise. Life and death is in the power of your tongue. I can pray for you all I want. This is a pray to get you turn blue. But life and death is in your tongue. You gotta speak it. And she said she is tired of being tormented with the spirit of fear. I was tormented with that fear. Because like I told the man, I had heart problems from birth. And I feared every day I was gonna die. But one day I told God, I'm tired of being fearful. I'm ready to leave. And that's where you are. You ready to leave. You couldn't move forward with fear, because fear is of the God.
That's right.
Fear is of the devil. And this was an attack of the devil to slow you up where God has for you. Come on, first lady. We're going to use you today. The dark Lord told me we're going to use this first lady. Come on. Come on, lay hands on your members. Lay hands on her. Lay hands. Spirit of fear. Spirit of fear. The Lord rebuke you. I declare that you be healed, be delivered, and set free of this spirit. And you need to talk to that spirit. And tell that spirit to get out your house. You are a child of God. You got to stand out to the devil. And let the devil know that I ain't in here no more. But I'm a nigga and do the work of God. Now, man, let this mind be in you. Which was also in Christ Jesus. This is an attack of the mind. This spirit has come to the mind. This fear has come to the mind. This mind. This mind. Let this mind be in you, which was also in Christ Jesus. Continue to walk in faith. of the Spirit come back. You got to stay in church and stay in front of the Lord, and God is going to use you. That's why you have the spirit of fear, so that you can't be used. You just like a woman of the nest. I'm one of the kids, you know what? But you are a woman of God, and God wants to use you. But he can't use you with that spirit of fear. When you get rid of that, you're going to go higher than you've ever gone in life. Tell the Lord thank you. Tell the Lord thank you. Be healed. Be delivered. Be set free.
As he drank this water, oh, bring a deliverance into his life, God. Lord, give him a hunger and a thirst after you. In the mighty name of Jesus, we claim it right now by the faith of the Son of God in Jesus' name. And it is so in Jesus' name.
Come on, thank you. Put your hands together. Put your hands together. I want you to take this water home. And I want you to put it in the ice box. And I don't want to know, you can whoever in the house, do not drink that water. That water is for your love. And one day he's going to go in there, he's going to drink that water, and he's going to change him. This is called the working of a miracle. It's because he drank the other stuff. Didn't need to go there. He drank the other stuff. But he needed to be drinking this. And when he gets through drinking this, he won't drink that other stuff no more. Did you hear what I said? God delivers have come in your house because you are a worker in the house of God. God got his eyes on you. God got his hands on you. And I want you to know my hands real quick, Bishop. Anoint my hands. Oh, God, I feel deliverance. I feel deliverance for your love. I feel deliverance in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. If you ask him for some water, you go grab that bottle and you give it to him. Because if God don't change him, it's going to be his funeral that he'll be going to next. Did you hear what I said? Why would I say that? Because God has given him chance after chance after chance. And when you go home, you tell him the prophet of God told him that his chances is running out. He will have to get right with God. He will have to get right with God. Because if he get right with God, he shall live and not die. The devil is trying to kill him. And a strange mother will come and take him out. A woman that's not meant for him will take him out because he's unsaved. But God is going to save your husband. Don't worry. Don't have a spirit of fear. You're a liar. You're a liar. Spirit of fear, you're a liar. You're a liar, woman. You should not have no spirit of fear. You should not have a spirit of fear. God going to do this thing. God going to do it. I said, God. I saw the spirit of fear grab on that quick. You're a lying woman. In Jesus' name, you're going to do it. Be blessed, woman of God. You're going to do it. I just want to prophesy to you. I prophesy to everybody. But you're my wife. And you've been sticking by me. And I told you that God was going to deliver you. Was going to set you free of this thing that you got. You're a lying wonder. You're a lying wonder. Say that you're a liar. Be healed. Be delivered. Be set free. This is coming against me. You're a lying wonder. I declare that you be healed. That you be set free. But you stayed to think and need. I told you that the well on last year, that they were drilling across the street. I told you that well was going to hit. I told you that well was going to produce. It's on the miracle house, it's on the Shankerville tape. I prophesied to you that well was going to produce. And you found out the other day that we went on the internet and we researched it. And we found out that one well got 10 wells in it. might as well bless it. You ain't gonna work no more. You got a new car coming, you got a new house coming, and you got a new ministry coming. Come on, give God some praise. Lay hands on this man. It's time for you to come off the road. I decree and I declare you are a man of God. I speak a new church to you. You're finna get married. You're finna get married. You got a wife coming. You got a new house coming. She been waiting on you. She glad to have you. And you're gonna be a blessing to her. While she be a blessing to you. You're coming off the road. You gotta go into full-time ministry. In the name of Jesus. And I decree in less than 1 year, you will be married. You will come off the road. And you will have your own church. In Jesus' name.
Jesus.
Come on, give God.
Who's going through some pain? Don't think you're the only one.
Or who hasn't felt some shame? No.
Don't think you're the only one.
Who's had hard times here?